Hello, here we are with Mookie Tenenbaum once more. We are exploring through these videos his philosophy, his disillusionism, his misalgic theory. And we are producing now this sort of longer videos. We had lots of short videos defining concepts in a more abstract way, addressing aspects of his system of thought. But we are now trying to apply these thoughts to reality as things happen. We are following the news. Not from a journalistic perspective, of course, we are not journalists, but trying to offer a philosophical view of what's going on. We are almost at the end of 2020 now. We are still amidst this ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, and we are going to discuss in this particular outing precisely the end of the year, the holidays, Christmas, New Year's Eve, these days from, of course, a disillusionist point of view. What do they mean for us? And what can the pandemic teach about this meaning?
Well, as you probably are aware, we are in the midst of a very, very tough second and third wave in Europe, in the US, of course. And what we are seeing is all the scientists behind the advising government saying you have to cancel Christmas. Okay, let me give you some numbers to have an idea. Every country, besides one exception, every country in Europe, every one of them, has not dared to cancel Christmas. You see, Christmas, and we have already the experience of Thanksgiving that happened three weeks ago. When you mix households, what you get is super contagion. I mean, you are really taking people who never meet each other. Suddenly you put them together, you close them in a closed place because it's winter. Windows closed, no mask, eating, drinking, singing, and whatever. And that is, if anybody is there, has a COVID, probably many of those who are with him are going to get sick with COVID. So the numbers are terrible. The question of mixing household is a disaster. And still, we still see it that they do it. Let me go a little bit back in history. Not very old history. In the month of April in Israel, it was the Easter holiday, the Jewish Easter, which is really a big meal eaten by a lot of people that who are invited. It's a big thing. It's the biggest event in the year, family-wise, I would say. That and New Year's, but that is probably the biggest one. And it was in the middle of the pandemic. The government says, the president and the prime minister begged people, please do not mix each other. And to make it sure, to make it that it will happen, there was a lockdown, a very hard lockdown with police in the street. You cannot move from where you are. So people have it at their home and they were very sad because they couldn't see their friends, they couldn't see their family, they couldn't see the children, the grandparents, you know, it was quite a disaster. But I have to remind everybody, at the same time, the prime minister and the president, both who were asking people not to mingle, they both broke the rules, and each of them brought one of their children to stay with them in that evening. A disaster. Of course, they begged for forgiveness, and again, I never understood the forgiveness in all this. I can ask forgiveness for somebody if I'm walking in the street and suddenly I don't look at him and I walk on top of him. Oh, I'm very sorry. I bump into him. I didn't mean to. How do you beg for being sorry for doing something willful? I don't know, but probably it's a question of me of understanding what it means to say I'm sorry. Yes, but this is little things. But thing happened again in Thanksgiving. The mayor of Denver and governors and other mayors and many politicians who asked people not to travel, who did it on purpose in television in front of everybody. Everybody was looking at it. In that situation, even, and then they went to be with their families. They even flew to one of them flew even to Mexico to have a wedding. I mean, really, a big thing. And of course, they asked, they were very concerned that they did that. But this is the funny part of it. But the question is, what does it take to politicians to understand that if you mingle people, people are going to die? And this is not a theory anymore. We know exactly how it works. Why will a host of politicians in France, in Spain, in Italy, in Germany, in Belgium, in Austria, why all of them will be will take the risk of not risk, I would say the temerity of bringing people to be together in a place where we are going to have a huge contagion and the hospitals will be a disaster. Why? When you have there is a unanimous voice among scientists, you don't do it. Please cancel Christmas. And this is the first question. Why do they do it? Why? You can begin with the democracy argument. Well, these people are going to vote next year or the year or 2 years from now, and they will remember who was the Grinch, who destroyed our Christmas, who stole our Christmas. That's the first argument, but that's not the only one. The other reasons they do it, one of them, of course, is to save the economy. We have to save the economy if we don't have Christmas. That's quite a weird argument in the case of mixing people together in a household, but it means also with the presents. You know, they were open for shopping, I remind you. Italy open for shopping, Spain open for shopping, France open for shopping, Germany. But even Merkel, who gave a speech, an emotion-laden speech about she cannot bear the idea of seeing so many people die, and therefore she's ruining people's Christmas, so they can only meet six people, children are not included, they could be 14 children, and they can be from four different households, depending on the land there, it could be two households, four households. You needed really a mathematician to be able to work out what you can do or what you can't do. It was quite easy. No Christmas, no New Year, period. There will be a lockdown, absolute, total lockdown from the 23rd till the 2nd or 3rd of January, or in Spain, till the 7th of January, because the Spanish have on the 6th, they have another Catholic feast that it's very important in Spain. So, why don't they do it? Again, why? Is it democracy only? No, there is other things behind it. You see, these people, they want to be on the good side of the Republic, not just because of votes. You see, there is a committee of investigation now who just gave some the preliminary decisions against the Swedish government, that government who was really genocidal in its. I mean, you can only think about the brutality of what they did, yes, trying to let everybody do whatever they want, and the death, the amount of old people, it was a disaster. And the committee accused them of the whole government of being responsible. And the king came out, I think, both angry at what happened, what he saw, and also trying to cover himself. Because here, we will start seeing cannibalism, mm-hmm. Yes, political cannibalism going on. But I want to explain that this is not only politicians. We have all the religious establishment doing the same. Yes, well, it's Christmas, you cannot cancel Christmas. What about God? What about this? What about that? Some of the churches says, don't come on the 24th. Yeah, that was like the big, but they still insist. I mean, churches in the Netherlands were open all the time with 30, 40, 50 people, and they were evidences of being contagious. They don't care. The illusions and their players were adamant about saving their own, their own job, really. It was their own job. But now it's not only their own job, but their own freedom, because there will be investigations all over the place, Florence, everywhere. There will be maybe Nuremberg-like kind of trials. Nuremberg, may I remind to the people who doesn't know, there were trials after the Second World War where the Nazis were tried for atrocities. This is not the same, but this time will be the same, yes? We don't know, because this is after the pandemic is gone. And then there is the personal issue. each one of these people, Merkel, Macron, Sanchez, or Conti, or whoever you have, Rutte in the Netherlands, they also have family. They have what we call the egosphere. You have one of the videos in our channel is about the egosphere. Egosphere is about 20, 30 people that surround you, that you are emotionally invested with them somehow. That means that misogynically, you are vulnerable to suffering from them. And imagine your mother starts saying, what do you mean? We don't have a Christmas, and their children and the family, and the pressure is very big on them. So this is also part of it. I mean, they're behaving humanly because they will not be able to have Christmas with their mother. Today, the Minister of Health, Secretary of Health of England, just said that he had to call his mother to say that Christmas was canceled because in London, they did cancel Christmas. What did it take them to do it? Well, they had to have a terrible spike in contagions because of the new strain, the one that I'm sure by when you hear this, you will know about it. So only London, Christmas was canceled. The rest of the country, nothing. Only the Christmas day, only 4 people, 6 people, and so forth. What do you think about all this, Florencio?
What I was meaning to ask you since a while ago now is you seem to be adding new sources of suffering that in a way, I guess, compete with the fear we experienced before COVID and contagion and sickness and death. Because you mentioned the economic suffering, you mentioned the emotional or the sentimental suffering for those who find very important to meet with family members and, I don't know, people they love in these holidays. And now we have some sort of symbolic suffering that has to do with being unable to fulfill the rights and traditions. So what I'm guessing is that maybe from your misalgic point of view, there's sort of a tug of war here at place between, of course, the material, this biological, the medical aspects of the problem, and other problems that are connected to these illusions of family, religion, tradition, but that might also be very strong in terms of suffering for the individuals involved.
Well, first of all, let me recap a little bit for some of our viewers. Disillusionism means that we live under three main illusions. That's the state, the religion, and the family. What I mean, they are illusions that if tomorrow you lose your memory, you have an attack of amnesia, the state is not the state, your religion is not your religion, and your family is not your family. So they are illusions. They are material parts inside of each one of these illusions. One of them are, of course, the politicians in the state, or the military, or anybody who work for the state, what we call the players. And then you have all the church clergy in each one of the religions, in Islam, in Christianity, Judaism, Buddhism, all of them. And you have in the family. In the family, your family does not have players, yes? They are just protagonists of your that group, but that group again, it is dependent on your memory. The second part that I have to explain is that the only thing we do in life is to run away from suffering. And illusions help us in doing so. Because if we believe there is a state that takes care of me, then I'm not afraid. If I believe there is a God that takes care of the rest of the world or my afterlife, that's it. I suffer less. And if I believe there is a family who will stand by me if there is a problem, who might have also an emotional relationship. In fact, you have an emotional relationship with all the three illusions, yes? You probably have in different levels, with hymns being sung in the church or your national anthem. There is the whole thing, the whole emotional part. But basically, all these three are illusions and we run away from suffering. What we're talking about here is that the players, those people who work for the state, those people who work in the church, they themselves are people. They have what I call, at the end of every process, there is a guy with a sandwich. So these are people with a sandwich. They're holding the sandwich. And their sandwich is what they have to defend. And their sandwich is a misalgic one, of course. It's the one to suffer as little possible. And they don't want to suffer tomorrow when they will be outvoted or tried in a court and sent to prison, or their mother not talking to them because she ruined her last Christmas, because many of the cases will be my last Christmas. Yes, I had that in my family. It was my last holiday. That happens. So what you have there is a misalgic calculus. What I do is I see what hurts more. But the interesting thing is that we have now, for the first time since the beginning of the pandemic, two different camps, the scientists and the players, politicians, the religion, and even your family members. Those are the two sides. So what makes sense is that if I'm a politician, I will listen to the science. And they did till now. I have to say, more, less than more. More, less than more, yes. Not really, nothing to write home about, but about it. And they sometimes look for the scientists that say what they wanted to hear. In Sweden is the case, yes, I don't have a word to give to that person who calls himself a scientist. And so they found, even Dr. Mengele in Auschwitz was a scientist, yes? But we talk about here the science. The science world says, cancel Christmas. No New Year, no celebrations. Do not mix households. That's a very clear message. And it's unanimous. And on the other side, you see exactly people doing exactly the opposite. Not unlimited. We limit it to three households, four households, something that makes no sense, that nobody will take care. And children, not counting children. I mean, who decided that children are not contagious? And again, children, we're talking about people with children under the age of 14, yes, not the toddlers, yes, we're talking about the whole range. So what happened? So it is materialism. What disillusionism is a very materialistic philosophy. That means there is only matter, there's nothing else. There is no souls, there is no gods, there is nothing that is not matter. That's what science is really taking with it as their banner, and idealism, yes, the ideas, the world of ideas, in which ideas are very important, in which they say we have to save the economy, which is also an idea, yes. There is no economy to save. There is everybody has his own economy, yes. The economy is an ideal. The economy is an illusion. Again, it's a collective illusion. So they are defending the indefendable, the undefendable. Yes, and this is for the first time we see the war between idealism and materialism, and guess who will be right? The terrible thing is that this will be paid in lives, dead people. The decisions of the government will result in the death of people, a lot of them. Again, this is not about disillusionism, it's not about the righteousness of it. It is just they don't say that. If you ask them, do you want people to die? Because that's what you should ask her. Is it more important Christmas than people dying? They will say, no, it's not the same, because we do it together, because we have decided, and people responsibility. And then they found, as I talked about cannibalism, yes? They will be, the cannibalism includes us. Oh, it's the public who did not wear the face mask, or they didn't do it, and the public, again, another illusion. There is no the public, there is Florencio, Muki, and each one of the people who are watching this video. There is no such a thing. But for them, it's part of the way the narrative they use, the discourse of the narrative they use to get away with. To get away with, then you can add to it whatever you want. What do you think, Florencio?
I'm guessing this date in particular, not because we are now approaching it, not because we are making a video about it, but these dates in particular show precisely how all the illusions can come together, because Christmas is at the same time religious, at the same time a family tradition, and now the state has a lot to say in the matter, siding with church or religion and with family for Christmas, and against what you say, which is the obvious materialistic view, from which the 25th of December is a day like any other for the virus to transmit, for people to be contagious to each other. But it's not a date like any other from the illusionary point of view. And I think this is what we are saying. It's the clash between the two views. I want to ask you about something you said in previous videos, which is that if a player cancels Christmas, this is something you can see. This is something that is very immediately evident. He canceled Christmas. If a player prevents contagion in a way that in a time from now amounts to lesser deaths than expected, this is impossible to point at. This is not something we will experience. Deaths avoided. How do you count that? How do you experience that?
It's like with the vaccine, the same thing. I mean, you get the vaccine.
Yes.
And you never get sick. There is no experience of not getting sick. Mm-hmm. That's what you say. There is no such experience. There is no causal, direct causal link between the people sitting in that table at that mm-hmm. Christmas table mm-hmm. with the windows closed. I remind everybody, no mask. Singing, eating, drinking, and then what drinking means, yes, what brings on. So we're talking about a disaster from any point of view, but you cannot say, because he drank that uh-huh. glass of wine, that person living in Milan died from COVID. But, you know, it's very funny, because they choose not to see the link, but when they ask you to vote, they see a direct link. If you don't vote, it's a disaster. What do you mean? If I don't vote, I don't vote. Nothing happens. The result will not be changed. I can vote or not vote. So they use the when it's good for them, because that's the reason that I said it's a narrative. When it's good for them in the discourse, when it's good for them, casual relation, you can go from voting to prime minister. Which of course, you need 500 million things that should happen, and one of them is that it will be by one vote. But when it's death, that scientists show you the link. You see, there is a link. Here there is no link in the voting. Here there is a link, and they chose exactly to look for another one. But I want to add one thing, and I want to make it clear. Today is Sunday, and we are making this video on Sunday. Perhaps Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday, some other countries will cancel Christmas. It doesn't matter anymore. They were ready to do it, and because of the new infection in England, they may use it as a pretext to cancel Christmas. We may not. They should. In fact, now it's too late. People have already prepared everything. They should have been told 2 months ago or a month ago, sir, there is no Christmas. One little point about what you say, the 25th of December, it is this date and no other date. There is I heard several several scientists, and that's the reason they're scientists, because they're materialists. They say, why don't you let do Christmas on June, when everything is finished, when you are already vaccinated, all of us. And of course, he does not understand anything, he or she, both. They were both he and a she. Both of them said that they don't understand. These people will suffer. This is not a good solution for them. The only solution, if you ask me, is to say, every time you did not invite somebody, somebody was saved. I cannot give you his name, but somebody was saved. That is the way to explain it to people. People have cooperated. Remind you, in April, the whole world went into a standstill. The whole world. Everybody did exactly what the government said. All governments were popular. All of them. Incredible. All of them. Suddenly, they were extremely popular. What happened? Happened that, of course, they are what they are. They are politicians. They make mistakes. They make this, and they didn't listen very well to the scientists. They did not. They started opening, and the whole thing the whole story we already know. So it's not that people were not, credibility was lost. And the credibility was lost, not because people stopped becoming skeptics. It's not the skeptic, the public becomes skeptic. It's because they, of course, because that's their job, with their sandwich, did what they did and had, and instead of accepting that this is the time of a science, the science, it's not the time for politics, it's not the time for religion. Of course, it was a lost case. One little thing that to add to the religious part. Do you know that half or a group, very large group of Muslims are not going to take the vaccines because they are made with gelatin made out of pork? Half of Judaism, that's not a problem because it's to save people, you are allowed to do it. But in Islam, apparently, it's a big problem. And vegans, let me remind you. So there will be people who will be dying, once again, because the religious idealism will supersede and will make people suffering. Because you have to understand, I understand everybody, even these people who are doing it. A person who prefers to die or to take the risk of dying and not taking pork, he is making a certain calculus. He's doing the numbers. And he thinks that he will suffer more if he will eat pork than if he will die. And that's his decision. And probably he's right. Because nobody knows about its own suffering like anybody. And one thing is for sure, I will never know what it feels to be somebody else. And that includes that guy who does not take the vaccine because it's pork.
We shall see. This is interesting.
We shall.
We'll carry on.
We shall see.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you later.
If you enjoyed the video, please like it, comment, and subscribe.